All lives have to matter, or it cannot work. It's pretty clear that our leadership class, for whatever reason, doesn't want it to work. Obviously, they don't. Look at what they're doing. When you hear people ascribe blood guilt to a specific racial group, when you hear them talk about the sin of whiteness, what you're watching is the death of our future as a country. We can't live in a nation of warring tribes. We know very well what that looks like because it's the history of the world. It's miserable and vicious and bloody. We can't allow that. Most Americans of all colors on some level understand this. They don't always have the words to articulate it, but they know it. When their kids come home from school with assignments to suggest that all races are not, in fact, equal, that some races are guilty and some are innocent, that some groups are oppressors inherently and others are inherently oppressed. In the universities, this is called critical race theory. So that's the term that most people go with. Critical race theory. That's what we so often debate on television. That's the clip we just showed you. But critical race theory is an inaccurate way to describe what's happening. Like so much academic jargon, the phrase critical race theory doesn't mean anything. It obscures rather than illuminates. It is designed that way. It is designed to confuse you. What's happening in our schools and our military and our government is both simpler and easier to recognize than that. It's not critical race theory. It's racism. Not neo-racism or reverse racism. Those are meaningless terms. It is race hate. It is peddled by the people in charge in the hope that it will make them more powerful. That's all it is. We haven't said that often enough or clearly enough. And because we haven't, because we've been tied up in some pointless debate about a concept that nobody can actually define, the race hate, and that's what it is, has oozed from the universities and it has infected the entire country, including at the very highest levels.